Ever since Lake Mungo released in 2008 to little fanfare, the film has managed to slowly but surely gain a cult following among horror fans, thanks to various Reddit threads as well as some high profile YouTubers giving the film some praise. Filmed as a faux documentary, Lake Mungo explores how the Palmer family deals with the traumatic loss of Alice Palmer, a well-loved daughter, sister and friend to many. As the surname may indicate to fans of Twin Peaks, Alice Palmer has many secrets, some explored within the film, while others left shrouded in mystery in a not too dissimilar way to Twin Peaks' own Laura Palmer. Set some time after the tragedy, the events in the film are mostly the accounts of surviving family members detailing the months that followed Alice's death, from the investigation to the emotional trauma left behind. The horror of Lake Mungo lies within the way writer-director Joel Anderson presents these two aspects of the aftermath, adorning what could be a conventional drama with the hallmarks of a classic ghost story. The family begin to catch glimpses of what seems to be spirits wandering the house, thanks to photographs and video recordings taken by the son Matthew. Lake Mungo resembles Blair Witch or Paranormal Activity in some ways, but in other ways is quite different, with the documentary style being part home footage, part formal filmmaking, yet some may hesitate to even place the film into the horror genre to begin with. Despite these visually creepy moments and a single yet brutal jump scare, the usual tropes of the genre do not seem present in the film. There's no overblown ending that is rampant in the low-budget found footage genre, or an ending in which the established believability of the film is discarded in favour of cheap frills. Franchises such as Paranormal Activity, as well as the film Devil's Due, spend the majority of their runtimes creating a sense of realness in the film, only to offer endings that often felt tacked on and rushed. With Lake Mungo, in terms of screen time, the vast majority is given to very formal interview sections with the family. Yet even if we ignore genre, there is undoubtedly something horrific that resides in the through line of Lake Mungo, a constant feeling of something feeling wrong. Perhaps then, as many fans of the film have argued in the past, the film is an exploration of the human psyche, seeking to display the way we tackle the grief of losing a loved one. Elizabeth Kubler-Ross's theory of what the stages of grief look like has become an often referenced guide to frame the thinking around the acceptance of death, suggesting the process involves five key steps: denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and finally acceptance. Applying this framework to Lake Mungo will provide insight into how the film achieves this tone of constant dread, perhaps explaining why it's become such a case of intense horror for so many of its fans. With the film mostly focusing on the perspective of the close family members and how they each dealt with their death in their own way, the five steps outlined can be attributed to certain characters more than others. June Palmer arguably exhibits the process the clearest within the film, potentially due to the later established connection she has with her daughter in an unknown psychic way, as displayed in the discussed dream they shared. Russell Palmer decides he should be the one to identify the body, believing June should not have to go through with the ordeal. Immediately, this allows June to begin to deny the death of her daughter, questioning her husband's initial ID of the body, suggesting he has made a mistake. This example already presents the process of grief beginning for the family, with June's immediate denial of the tragedy playing into those who surrounded her as well. Yet, as will soon become clear, denial becomes an underlying theme throughout all of Lake Mungo, being a constant throughout most of the process displayed within the film. Anger, however, is not so easy to pin down here. This could quite easily be due to when the events of the film take place, as many of those more intense emotions felt by those closest to Alice following the event have begun to subside, allowing the family to give more of a reflective account of the things they experienced. Yet towards the end of the film, the family discusses one of the darker elements of Alice's secretive nature, referred to in the film as the Toohey video. All the viewers told is that Alice had been in a sexual relationship with her far older next door neighbours, with the level of consent in the affair being left undisclosed and potential child grooming being hinted at. What increasingly becomes complicated when analysing anger as the second step of the grieving process is that within the film all these steps barring acceptance are intertwined with one another. Much like denial, the idea of bargaining is what Lake Mungo bases most of its horror elements upon. As previously mentioned, Matthew Palmer presents various photographs and videotapes that seem to feature an apparition. Immediately, the mother and father begin to desperately hope that it is Alice, either alive or in some spiritual form. This leads the family back into that underlying form of denial, as June demands that the grave of her supposed daughter is dug up as she accuses Russell of potentially misidentifying the body, an idea that he begins to believe himself. Ultimately, the truth comes pouring out as the body is confirmed to be Alice upon excavating her grave. Matthew Palmer reveals that he has been fabricating the footage, and it is never fully explored within the narrative why Matthew decided to partake in this cruel creation of the footage, as his mother comments that to this day she still does not know why he did what he did. Perhaps this is Matthew's own way of dealing with the grief of his tragic loss, doctoring photographs and video to contribute towards his own inner denial that he has lost his sister. Eventually, this leads to June getting in contact with a spiritual medium, hoping that he can allow her to get in contact with Alice in some form, with the psychic's legitimacy also being left unclear. Although the film takes place after the events that are discussed, the family are all presented throughout much of the film as being in some state of depression. The viewer is taken through the narrative with fresh eyes, piecing together their own version of events as they unfold, whereas the family have already experienced all these events firsthand. In comparison to the first three stages of the process, depression is a far more private mental state, making it difficult to suggest whether any member of the Palmer family is experiencing this stage. Perhaps then the transition into acceptance from depression is the next step in discussing the process within the film. Towards the conclusion of the narrative, a final revelation is revealed to the viewer, as the Palmer family detail the discovery of Alice's mobile phone. The phone was buried in secret by Alice some time before her death, and upon inspecting the phone, a video is found that offers up even more questions than answers, as a haunting video recorded by Alice seems to show her future deceased self rushing towards her. Although the family has always understood that Alice tragically drowned, resulting in her passing, the mysterious circumstances surrounding her death could be the key to why the family may be stuck in a depressive state. Upon this revelation, one would expect the Palmer family to regress back into a previous stage of the grieving process, perhaps once again bringing themselves to deny the death due to the evidence they have discovered. Yet the family takes this final revelation as closure, despite a lack of understanding of what they've uncovered, and it's clearly similar to the doctored footage from Matthew. They take this as the last piece of the puzzle, perhaps the confirmation of their previous doubts and feelings towards the ambiguity of Alice's death in this form of the video allows them to finally move towards some semblance of closure. As the end of the film is reached and the family have conveyed all that can be, they make a decision to leave the family home and try to give the tragedy that has consumed their entire being some closure. Upon the film's timeline of events reaching the current day and the viewer witnessing the family during the acceptance stage, the film ends with a still image of Russell, June and Matthew in front of the home as they say their goodbyes, leaving everything behind them. This would seem to be a suitable conclusion in the narrative, and thus to this entire concept in this essay, yet there is an elephant in the room in this whole analysis, coming from the arguably most horrifying moment presented in the entire film, seen in Lake Mungo's hair-raising ending. As the mentioned still image seems to signal the ending of the story, the frame then slowly zooms in towards the home, revealing the outline of someone lurking in the window, much like one of Matthew's photos. The credits begin to roll and the film presents three moments from the film to the viewer once more, being revealed that there is something we did not notice, a spirit has been there the whole time. The ending stinger is an absolute sucker punch that throws the entire film into a new light, suggesting that the initial suspicions from the family were always warranted. This may again suggest that the closure felt by the Palmer's family is potentially unearned, similar to the discovery of the videotape offering another potential mystery. Yet it is not the family who is provided with this final shock, it is the viewer, leaving the audience to question everything they have taken over of the course of the narrative, while equally allowing the book to remain closed on the Palmer family and their emotional journey. Lake Mungo, unlike many of its genre counterparts, opts to relish in the horror of everyday life, detailing an event that, while being exaggerated to some degree for the use of supernatural elements in order to create a mystery for the viewer to be hooked upon, is something that almost everyone will go through, the experience of grief. The process of grief may not be represented here as a clear step-by-step experience, yet as this video has shown, the steps that Matthew, June and Russell all partake in are in flux throughout the entire film, with each member dealing with grief in their own personal way. That is why Lake Mungo has earned itself such a reputation as a truly horrifying film, with the ending credits being arguably the most celebrated aspect of the film. It asks the viewer to question what grief truly is. The concept of a family member lingering on after death may allow some form of comfort for people, much like it did for the Palmer family, yet for others it provides a haunting concept, allowing Lake Mungo to delve deep into one of the most common fears among humanity, the unknown nature of death. Thank you for watching to the end of this video essay from Clapper. If you would like to see all the written content from the team, then head on over to www.clapperltd.co.uk for the latest reviews on films, TV, as well as interviews and features similar to this one. Be sure to check out our range of podcasts too, from our weekly roundtable discussion Clappercast, which discusses all the latest releases, as well as Uncut Gems, which takes a look at forgotten films and decides if they should be given a second chance. If you'd like to support the team at Clapper for our written content as well as video content such as this, then head over to our Bonfire store to nab yourself some merch that will support the team in future content.